Well, traders, I'm not going to continue trading today. As you can see, I've got a red day today, and it's been a while, but it is a red day. I have to take it as it is. I don't think I'm going to continue trading because I have the feeling now that everything I'm going to do next is just to compensate for my loss, and I don't want to be there. I don't want to take any greater risk than I've already done. And as you can see here, I had a loser in Tesla, I had a winner in Boeing. Spotify was my best trade. Have a loser in mRNA. Actually, two trades in mRNA. One was the loser, the second one was a winner. And initially, I had a bigger loss, but turned out to be a smaller loss because of my second trade. Small winner in APRN, and a very unpleasant two losers in Google, which, in fact, they are the reason why I'm red for the day. The interesting part about what happened today was, let's take a look at the S&P and the Nasdaq. You know, I often talk about the direction of the market. Tell you what, it was an easy day to trade today, although I didn't manage to make money today, but it was an easy day to trade today. Look at the S&P 500. We started up with a gap up of 2%, Nasdaq approximately the same thing. It was anticipated, it could be anticipated, that the S&P would be under pressure, as it always, it usually is when there's a big gap up. So it did come down. So initial direction was down. It could have been anticipated. It was anticipated. I just got into the wrong trade. That's it. And once it started pulling back up, we could have a good idea that it's going to move over the highs, because that's what happens when you've got a big gap up. You usually get a gap and go on big days like this. So initial move down, profit taking or whatever it is, then a move over the highs. Then, if you may remember, before we've seen this red candle, I thought we're going to get a pullback because we were a bit extended, and we did come down, and then we stopped, and then we returned to the highs. What's interesting to see here is, if you take a look at the candles here, these are 5-minute candles. Nasdaq, two candles down, four candles up, two candles down. Look here at the S&P. Two candles down, four candles up, two candles down. Now, look at what happens in Nasdaq. After we moved down, we came out with two strong candles which moved us over the highs. If I take a look at the S&P, it was right over here. That's the second candle here. So by the second candle, the S&P was trending higher, but was not over the highs. You could think that the S&P maybe just went up a bit and maybe possibly continue lower, but no. Once you've seen the Nasdaq moving over the highs, it was very, very likely that the S&P would move over the highs too. And you know, that's what drives the stocks that we are buying, to move over the highs. So we market direction could have been easily anticipated today. And the way the market behaved, I should have made money today. I should have earned money today, but I definitely did not. And it's one of these days. But I can definitely say that it should have been different. I don't know if if it has anything to do with luck, bad luck, or anything like that, but I definitely have an unpleasant losing day. By the way, it's not as much as I mentioned earlier, because you can see here that I still have 400 shares of Spotify, which are up $2,300. So just under, what, 3,000 something? So not such a disastrous day, but a red day, certainly a red day. Should have been green with the market direction so clear as it is today, but it just happens. Thank you very much for trading with me today. Sorry I couldn't help too much. I hope to do better tomorrow. I'll see you all tomorrow. Thank you for participating again, and see you all. Bye, traders. Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet Trading Room for a free 14-day trial. TradeNet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its Trading Room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.